Today we're going to take a look at hypergraph proper colorings. A proper coloring of a hypergraph is an assignment of colors to the vertices of the hypergraph such that no edge of the hypergraph that is of size 2 or greater has all vertices of the same color. A proper K coloring is a proper coloring that uses K colors. In the example on the left, we see a 2 coloring that's proper, because there's no edge with at least 2 vertices where all vertices receive the same color. In the example on the right, we see a 2 coloring that's not proper, because the edge of size 2 is monochromatic. Proper hypergraph colorings generalize the notion of proper graph colorings, as if we consider graphs to be 2 uniform hypergraphs, the proper graph coloring condition that no pair of adjacent vertices receive the same color is equivalent to the condition that no edge is monochromatic. Notice that, unlike in graph theory, a proper hypergraph coloring allows us to assign adjacent vertices the same color. All that matters is that we don't assign the same color to all of the vertices in an edge. Just like in graph theory, we define the chromatic number of a hypergraph to be the smallest number of colors needed to properly color that hypergraph. As long as a hypergraph has some edge of size 2 or greater, we have to use at least 2 colors in a proper coloring, meaning the chromatic number will be greater than 1. Moving on, note that color classes, which are sets of vertices assigned the same color, form a partition of the vertex set of the hypergraph. Next, remember that there are usually 2 notions of independent sets in hypergraph theory. Strong independent sets, which are sets of vertices that are pairwise non-adjacent, and weak independent sets, which are sets of vertices that do not contain an edge as a subset. Using this information, we can make a connection between graph colorings and hypergraph colorings. In graph theory, each color class of a proper coloring is an independent set in the graph theoretic sense because vertices of the same color are not adjacent. This carries over nicely to hypergraphs. Every color class of a proper hypergraph coloring is a weak independent set, as long as the hypergraph doesn't have edges of size 1. This is because the fact that no edge is monochromatic in a proper hypergraph coloring means that edges of size at least 2 cannot be subsets of any color class. We can see this in the following hypergraph. Together with the fact that color classes form a partition of the vertex set, we can now say that a proper hypergraph coloring is a partition of the vertex set into weak independent sets, provided the hypergraph does not have edges of size 1. This helps us generalize bipartite graphs to bichromatic hypergraphs, which are hypergraphs with chromatic number 2. If a hypergraph is bichromatic, such as our first example, then we can partition its vertices into 2 weak independent sets. This is similar to how if a graph is bipartite, its vertices have a partition into 2 independent sets. If our hypergraph has no edges of size less than 2, such as the one shown here, then this also means pictorially we can arrange the vertices of the hypergraph into 2 columns, each column being one of the color classes, and that there will be no edge that's entirely within one of the columns. Next, like in graph theory, we can find bounds for the chromatic number of a hypergraph using certain parameters of the hypergraph. We'll start by assuming that our hypergraphs do not have edges of size 1. Since every color class is a weak independent set, no color class can have size greater than the weak independence number of the hypergraph. So, if we're given the weak independence number of a hypergraph H with n vertices, then we can say that the chromatic number must be greater than or equal to n divided by the weak independence number. Here's an example of a hypergraph whose chromatic number is greater than n divided by the weak independence number. Next, Here's an example of a hypergraph whose chromatic number is exactly n divided by the weak independence number. Notice that equality between the chromatic number and n over the weak independence number means we can partition the vertices such that each part is a maximum weak independent set. Finally, also using the weak independence number, we can construct an upper bound for the chromatic number of a hypergraph. Notice that if S is a weak independent set in a hypergraph H, then we can assign the same color to all of the vertices in S, and a unique color to each vertex not in S, and the result would be a proper coloring of H. The number of colors used in such a coloring is 1, plus the number of vertices not in S. The larger we make S, the fewer colors used in this coloring. If S is a weak independent set of maximum size in H, then it has size alpha of H, meaning there are n minus alpha of H vertices not in S, so the coloring we just described would use 1 plus n minus alpha of H colors. This gives us our upper bound for the chromatic number. For the hypergraph shown here, this upper bound is greater than the actual chromatic number, which is just 2. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and click the like button. Have a great day.